got somebody to come in here this morning that I've had a chance to get to know since just over a year ago, and talking to him about a lot of different things, and you know, very impressive guy. Guy that came from North Hills High School, you know, in Pittsburgh, and was, you know, won just about every high school award that you could imagine. You know, Player of the Year in Pennsylvania, you know, High School Gatorade Player of the Year, you know, all those things. And then he took his talents to Penn State and was a linebacker, you know, at Penn State, played, was only there for 3 years, left after his junior year. You know, one of the things that was all Big Ten, was an All-American, was the Butkus Award winner, the Chuck Bednarik Award winner. Okay, if anybody can go back and take a look, he was one of the guys that, you know, against Illinois, ended up jumping over linemen, making a sack, and then was the second pick. Was the second pick of the 2000 draft, you know, with the Washington Redskins, and then played 6 years for the Redskins, and then went and played 1 year, you know, with the Giants, and now he's back here. And one of the things that he did while he was playing, okay, he got involved with the media, got involved with Comcast, and now he's kind of branched out, where he has his own radio show, you know, here in this area. He's doing a lot of things, has just started his own company. He's got just done very, very good things within the community. Works with young people, but very talented, very smart, understands what you're going through. And as I was talking to LaVar, one of the things he mentioned when we were talking, he said he wanted to come in, talk to you guys before we got started with spring practice. So we're blessed, you know, we're blessed this morning to have LaVar Arrington here to speak to us. So let's bring him up, let's give him a nice round of applause.
Thank you, Coach. Just so I could get the feeling again. So it's a good feeling. So while I get myself together, because I get so filled up and I get pumped up about being around what y'all are doing, I'm gonna let y'all look at this. Now, before y'all look at it, just know my father's a wounded warrior. Lost both his legs in Vietnam. So coming up, always been a military dude. So when I say something means like the world to me, and it's like I'm willing to die for it. When I say I'll die for it, when I look at you and tell you I'll die for you, I really mean it. I don't just say it to say it. So this is the Navy SEALs. I'm a big fan of the SEALs. And I always took their creed. And their creed always was something that when I worked out, you know, when I did what I did, it's something that always resonated in my mind, because it has to mean the world to you. It has to mean life. Now, this might sound crazy to you. You got to be willing to die for it. If you're going to be the best at what it is that you're going to do, you got to be willing to die for it. Y'all are special. Y'all are elite.
people still sleep right now. Dreamland, dream world. We right here, because we different. I want y'all to watch this. It's short, but I want y'all to listen. Listen closely. I know it's early. Listen closely to what these men say in this video. Because what I want you to do is, I want you to take out the fact that they're saying armed forces, and I want you to put Maryland football in there. Everything you hear, I want you to put yourselves on that screen. I want every last one of y'all to envision yourselves giving this speech for Maryland football. Y'all got me?
Yeah.
All right, now let's run. See how we fix it, right? We're good.
In times of war or uncertainty, there is a special breed of warrior ready to answer the nation's call. A common man with uncommon desire to succeed. Forged by adversity, he stands alongside America's finest special operations forces to serve his country, the American people, and protect their way of life. I am that man.
My Titan is a symbol of honor and heritage. Bestowed upon me by the heroes that have gone before, it embodies the trust of those I have sworn to protect. By wearing the trident, I accept the responsibility of my chosen profession, and it is a privilege that I must earn every day.
My loyalty to country and team is beyond reproach. I humbly serve as a guardian to my fellow Americans, always ready to defend those who are unable to defend themselves. I do not advertise the nature of my work, nor seek recognition for my actions. I voluntarily accept the inherent hazards of my profession, placing the welfare and security of others before my own.
I serve with honor, on and off the battlefield. The ability to control my emotions and my actions, regardless of circumstance, sets me apart from other men. Uncompromising integrity is my standard. My character and honor are steadfast. My word is my bond.
We expect to lead and be led. In the absence of orders, I will take charge, lead my teammates, and accomplish the mission. I lead by example in all situations.
I will never quit. I persevere and thrive on adversity. My nation expects me to be physically harder and mentally stronger than my enemies. If knocked down, I will get back up every time. I will draw on every remaining ounce of strength to protect my teammates and accomplish our mission. I'm never out of the fight.
We demand discipline. We expect innovation. The lives of my teammates and the success of our mission depend on me. My technical skill, tactical proficiency, and attention to detail. My training is never complete.
We train for war and fight to win. I stand ready to bring the full spectrum of combat power to bear in order to achieve my mission and the goals established by my country.
Once it's over, there's no coming back. So when I say life and death, when your football days are over, dead and gone. Now sitting here in the moment, you might be sitting here thinking,
tired. You might be sitting here thinking, my girlfriend getting on my nerves. Can't stand my coach. Why he don't like me? This dude sitting in front of me think he better than me. I don't feel like being here. I don't even like football. Might be sitting here thinking, I'll ball out tomorrow. Can't wait to jump into the meeting room. Love my coach. Love my chick. There are a whole bunch of things you're thinking about. One of the hardest things to do is to balance out your thoughts, to discipline your mind. What's even more difficult is y'all collectively as a group doing that. Think about what it is for you to do it for yourself. And then now think about what it would be for y'all to do it all together. These are the challenges that make or break you as an individual and as a team. Think about that. Can you balance your studies with the game? Can you balance the game with your studies? Every single time you cut a corner, you're not only cheating yourself, you're cheating everybody else in here. Whether it be coaches or whether it be players. Every single time you don't take that extra step, you not only cheated yourself, but you cheated the entire team. Now that video, I'm just, look at that man's eyes. Do they have the same situation as us? Do they have the same challenges as you? Yeah. Are they going to like who's telling them what to do all the time? Are they going to want to do the things that they have to do all the time? Absolutely not. But it's the ability to understand that we are made through adversity. There is no perfect scenario. And what y'all trying to accomplish? Definitely ain't no perfect scenario. A lot of moving parts. Let me throw this one at y'all. I got this deal. Call it the chain game. I love this, right? Because I could be standing up here in front of y'all and I could be like, you know what? When I was in high school, I used to do cats. I was a tailback. I ran for over 4,000 yards in quad A and West PA football. We played football. We played football in West PA. I balled. I played linebacker too. Played safety. Played corner. Played quarterback. Played receiver. Played tight end. Hell, I would have did whatever coach asked me to do. So if I needed to play guard for us to win, I'd have did it. When my teammates went down, and I had to stand in there and play his position, I would have did it. You know that? That teammate that went down, he would have did it. I could sit here and tell y'all that. I could sit here and tell y'all I went to Penn State as the number one recruit in the country. I could do that. I can tell you I went to Penn State and became the best player. Forget linebacker. I became the best player in the country outside of Peter Ward. He was a bad boy. What I did, it matters as a memory. And I'll get to that. Because it does. It's relevant.
in one regard. But where it's not relevant is the here and now. What's relevant is y'all's opportunity. Because either you want to do something that no one's ever done before, or you want to be just like everybody else. What did he say? A common man with what? Okay, to what? To succeed. We are all common men. And if we understand that we are common men, then I can look to my left and I can look to my right and know that we are common men together. We may come from different places, look different. Some of us might be prettier than others. Some may be way more prettier than others. I always looked at myself as a sexy dude. I wasn't pretty or I wasn't ugly, but I was sexy. That might be you. We come from different places, guys. But here's what's important. What did he say? When I accepted that Triton, when he accepted that, what did it say? What did he say? Y'all remember? He accepted that, knowing that this is my profession, which is an honor bestowed upon him, that he cherishes and honors based upon the ones who came before him. An honor that he has to earn what? Every single day. Every single day. When you chose to come here and be a family, it's just us in here. Nothing else matters. It's just us. When you chose for it to be just us, and each and every last individual in here makes it us, then you accepted the profession that went with it. A given honor to have merit across your chest that you have to earn each and every day. No matter the adversity, no matter the triumph, no matter the challenge, you chose this. So the bonds between all of you is different than anything else. If you're gonna be special, if you're gonna do something different, if you're gonna accomplish something different from anybody else, then y'all all got to believe it. And you got to spend your time executing it. Can't be, I'm cool, I'm over here, this is my home, you know, I'm from Oxon Hill, he from Arrington Hill. Cool, we over here. This dude from somewhere I ain't never even heard of. I don't even fool with this dude. Y'all know each other's names? Let me tell you something. In a perfect world, y'all all love each other. In a perfect world, y'all all love each other. I got two brothers. Born brothers, because y'all my brothers too. I got two born brothers that I grew up with. Love them to death. Does that mean that I always like them? I owe my football career to my older brother. Used to whoop my ass. He loved me. I think he loved me. He says he does. Used to beat me down. I started lifting because I got tired of them beating me up. That's how I started lifting. I went downstairs, grabbed my dad's rusty weights, started working out on the bench, started pedaling on that old crickety bike, and I was down that joint. All I could think about was, next time he tries me, he gonna have to see me. That's all I could think about. What's crazy is, it persisted for over a year. I'm going down, I don't even think anybody even knew. I'm down that joint. He ain't gonna punch me in the head like that, man. Get on that bike, he ain't gonna be ready for me. Sure enough, that day came too.
Over something little too, but I just wanted it. Cleaning our room, you get money to go to the mall. Now, depending on how clean your room was, and depending on how much they gave you allowance-wise, and my brother was tidy. I was a mess.
But I was good at cleaning up my mess, like, you know, push something here, you know, stick that there. It wasn't correct, but it appeared to be good.
Mom comes in the room, she looked around. She just gave a look around. It's like, oh, everything's good, da da da, this and that. All right, we're gonna go to the mall. I remember some Jordans just came out. I was like, I'm gonna give me a pair of Jordans, I'm gonna give me a shirt, and I'm gonna get this video game that I want. Had it all planned out. If I had got the entire allowance. So I'm pumped up. Yes. My J's. Game, and I hear, hey, wait, Mom. Look under his bed.
I hate him.
So she sure enough pulled up the bed. It's like old cake boxes, garbage, shoes, clothes. I think I had
a sock that was standing up. So she goes, oh.
You're not getting the whole thing. Let's go. He's standing right there at the door, smiling. I got him whooping. I'm a bad kid. Like, I was the one that pushed you to have him spank me. And my brother was always the golden boy, so he'd be there laughing, like, while he'd spank, he'd be laughing, like, kind of like, Glory, you know, you're getting spanked. He's looking like, well, anyway, that's another tangent. But he's standing there smiling at me. And I was like, this is it. This is the time I have been waiting for. It's going down. He walked up on him, and he didn't beat me up for so long. He kind of walked towards me like, this is some easy work, and then I'm going to get my allowance, go get what I want. So he kind of walked towards me. It wasn't like he was going to be scared or run away. He came, he's like, I know what this is. So he comes walking towards me, and all I could remember doing was grabbing him by his head, grabbing his pants, and I DDT'd him. Right? I DDT'd him. Then he gets up. And I backed up off of him. And then I punched him in his chest as hard as I could. And he went back. And we was about to get it going again, right? And then I could tell he felt that power. He felt that power, dog. So when he came in, he came, whoa. So I think he tried to change his approach because it wasn't going to work the way he had historically beat me up. So he kind of changed his approach because he was nice with his hands. I hit him in his chest and it was like, okay, he's taller than me at this point. I'm not going to try to punch him. I got to figure out something different. So he gets down and he tries to rush me. I'm ready. I'm strong. Wait, say, look, I should be using that. I was built physically strong at this point. Strong enough to destroy my enemy. And I got a hold of his head. And we ran out the room. And I just kept going. And I put his head in the wall. So bad, my dad had to break it up. point is,
it's my brother. You gonna fight.
You gonna disagree. I always like your coaches to dads or uncles and stuff. Dad came down the hall, he had to break it up. He had to talk to us. Love my dad.
Didn't always like my dad.
Y'all gotta understand the dynamic here. There's not one player in here that they didn't want here. Let's keep that in mind. If you're in this room, it's because they want you here. Whether it appears to you that they fooled with you or not, you're here because they wanted you here. And all that you hear on some politics or anything like that, throw that out the door. That's an age-old discussion that's bullshit.
Excuse my language. If you hear, you are. Case closed. You got limited scholarships, you got limited walk-on. So if you're in this room, that means those men back there believe that this is the group of guys that they assembled to be able to have a chance to win.
Don't use your thoughts on unnecessary things. Comes back to discipline. It comes back to being willing to stand in there for your fellow man. We are common men with what? All right. To what? Right.
Uncommon desires to succeed. There's not one coach that can succeed without the rest of the coaches and the team. There's not one player, I don't care how good you are, I don't care how many awards you win, if you're an All-American, there's not one player in here that can succeed in what it is that y'all trying to succeed at if y'all not doing it together. So back to the chain gang, right? Came up with this chain gang.
Strongest link. If every last one of us in here is the strongest link, what it say on there? I want to be led and I am a leader. I never quit.
If I get knocked down, I get up every single time. If everybody in here is the strongest link, do we have a chance?
If every last swinging soul in this room is the strongest link, do we have a chance? Think about it, man. Because for the weakest link is only as strong as you are. So if you effing up out there, if you don't take your integrity that you have on the field and take it off the field, and the integrity off the field that you take onto the field, if that isn't ever present, you are a weak link.
And this is only as strong as how weak you are as that weak link. With a show of hands, who wants to be the weakest link in this room? Quick, show of hands. Who's the weakest link? Coaches? Weakest link? Show of hands.
Look around. See any hands up? Y'all see any hands?
No hands. That means no weak links.
If y'all are all the strongest link in this chain of Maryland football, which this road that you travel will only come one time in your life, then the experiences that y'all create will last a lifetime. that you're walking one time.
One time. You could go play all the turkey bowls you want. Flag football, pickup football. You can do it all you want. I guarantee you, you will never have the opportunity to feel the way you feel right now. I know. And I can still do it in my mind. You don't get this back. So how this team is remembered will be how you're remembered. I said, I'll touch on what I did because it's relevant later. Well, here's later. Here's what's relevant to that, to what you do now and what it means going forward. The Sean Merrimans, the Hendersons, Lamont Jordan, Boomer. How will you be remembered? What's your legacy? What will be your legacy? When you come back through these doors and you got kids that are almost ready to come to this school, when your football days are long gone and over, what is your legacy? How will this group be remembered? What did you put in place? What brick did you leave here to build this? Or are you a distant memory? Never to be discussed. Or to even be referenced as, don't want to end up like that. How do you want to be talked about when you leave here? I know this. When I come back and I'll stand on that sideline, I'm standing on that sideline with pride here. What kind of call is that? What kind? I don't have to feel anything other than pride when I go back to school. What you gonna feel? I see my teammates, we never won a national title. But I'll be damned if we didn't give it everything we had. It's ranked number one. For number one, number two for 9 weeks. We get beat on a bomb, a Hail Mary bomb, last second bomb. They kick a field goal and beat us. So wasn't in our cars to win a national title. I'm not saying national title or bust, but are we working to win a national title? Are you working to win your conference? Last I checked, whether you get a national title bid or not, if you beat everybody in front of you, what does that make you? Huh? Say it like you mean it, because I can't hear you. It makes you a champ. It makes you unbeaten. That makes you the best. Is that what y'all want? That's what y'all want, man. But y'all got to understand today, you got to take what you feel, what you do, you got to balance it all out, and you got to take it to a whole nother level. Today, start with today. If you take the thought of pulling together, all of us, pulling together, and y'all build that day by day, hold each other accountable. See, here's why you got to love one another. Because just as hard as y'all may fight against one another or have disagreements
or not feel like this person likes me, or they're treated fairly and I'm not, or they got a fair chance, I didn't. The reason why y'all gotta love each other is because if each and every last one of you are accountable for one another, you will not let each other fail. Do not let each other fail. If one of us fails, then we have failed. If there is an empty seat in here because somebody did not do what they needed to do on the classroom or as a family member of this family, we have failed. Does it mean that much to you? Is somebody not in here today that should be here? Yes, no? Is somebody that's supposed to be on this team not sitting in this room today? Yes, no? Huh? Yeah. We failed. Because that's your brother that isn't in this room today. In some way, somehow, we have to understand for one another, if we create that bond, it don't matter if I go to your house during spring break or not. We don't have to be the best of friends, but we're brothers. So we have to hold each other accountable. It can't be, hey, messing up, man. Sorry for him. Sad story. Sad for me. If y'all feel that way about one another, you will fail. But if you are accountable for one another, it's amazing what y'all will be able to accomplish. It will be amazing. And that ride, when y'all do it together, and y'all believe in one another, and y'all love each other, and you willing to lay it down for the next man next to you, and the next man next to him, it is one of the most amazing journeys that you will ever be on, and then that's your legacy. And y'all will always have it. That's something they can't, no one and nothing can take away that. You will always have it. Come in as teammates, leave as brothers. Whatever they say in the song. Listen, man. I'm not telling y'all nothing y'all haven't already heard. But sometimes you need to really listen and reevaluate and reassess and recommit yourself. Commit yourself to leading by example at all times. Commit yourself to never sacrificing the integrity of what you represent, which is a Maryland football player. People walk around wanting to be Maryland Terrapins. That's what y'all are. Last time I saw somebody fall asleep while I was talking, we went to blows. Don't fall asleep while I'm talking. But that's what I'm talking about. Accountability. I know you're tired. It's early. Then y'all got to go do more. I get it. But if you want to be the best, it's called sacrifice. You sacrifice that sleep. You sacrifice being tired. I don't give a damn about tired. You got your chance now. And if you got sleep that's too important, if you got something else that's too important to you, you probably in the wrong place. Because this isn't the sport for you. Fatigue makes cowards of us all. Cowards of us all. Be accountable. Sacrifice. If not, stand up if you're going to fall asleep. Do whatever it is you need to do to be what you need to be for him, for him, for him,
for him, for him. I'm not gonna go around the whole room. For everybody in here, do what you need to do to be accountable for the other people that are being accountable for you. Now, if you take that passion, if you take that commission, and you apply that, then y'all all gonna feel it. And you all gonna execute that. And that will become your personality. That will become how you are identified. I used to come out on that field, you know how I was identified? It just looked like he's gonna kill somebody. It looks like he's gonna, you know why? You know why? Because I am trying to knock you out. You ready, boy? I'm ready. You ready to see? Can they see you? No. How you feel, Battle Cat? How you feel, Battle Cat? I feel good. Because I'm prepared. And I know the dudes around me are ready to go to war just like I am. You bring that, you're going to be all right. Class, studies, eating right, doing the right things, staying away from trouble, those are all things that y'all have to hold each other accountable for. I promise y'all this, if y'all do it, just try. Get everything out of this that you possibly human possibly can get out of this. Just try. Don't be too good for one another. Don't be too cool for one another. Just try. I appreciate y'all giving me the time, man. If y'all want to ask me anything, any questions, I'll open it up to y'all. Make sure you are the strongest link. Make sure you are the strongest link. And make it a point and a priority, even when it's not, even when it's not convenient. Make it a point to lead by example. Make it a point to lead by example, guys. It's not always easy, and I know that. I know what y'all going through. It's not always easy. I know that. But make it a point to try. A quitter will never win, and a winner will what? I love y'all, man. When I say I love y'all, I mean it from the heart. I don't even know y'all. I don't know your names, but I know you. I know you, and I love you. Did y'all get that? One day, I hope that you give back the same way. One day, I hope you got it so much so that you give back, because we are a family, all of us. I'm just from a different generation, but we still family. When you throw that helmet on, you put them pads on, you gotta endure the things that y'all have to endure. Our brotherhood is forged through blood, sweat, and tears. I love y'all for that. The fact that y'all do what you do will always keep me alive. When you're finished, the fact that the people that come after you do what they do will always keep you alive. Do your part. Accept your role. Be coachable. Fulfill your duty, so that you can complete your mission. All right? Yes, sir. Y'all got any questions? Any
If I have any questions, feel free to ask. If not, I wish y'all all the luck in the world. Do what y'all need to do. And I look forward to coming to check y'all out, man. All right?
We were been truly blessed, you know, this morning to have LaVar here. And, you know, I'm sitting back there just listening to what he's saying. You know, you can just feel the energy and the passion that he has, you know, for this game, but also for what you guys are doing. Because he lived it. And if you ever watched him play, and then if you had the opportunity like I've had, to get to know him and see what his passion is now in life is to help other people, you know, to achieve some of the things that he's achieved in his lifetime. That's truly special. You know, he is a very special person because he is one who wants to give back and have others like you achieve opportunities that he's achieved. So like I said, we are very special. So make sure you keep this in the memory bank. Because I guarantee you don't realize just how special, you know, these times are. Here's a guy who lived it. And you can feel it, you can see it. So take this with us. And so on behalf of our team, we want to, even though it's a Penn State guy, you know, we're going to give him one of our pride hoodies to wear, and I know he'd wear that with pride, and he knows that he can come back anytime, and we're practicing to see you guys, and like I said, man, we've been very, very blessed this morning to have LaVar here with us, so let's give him another round of applause. What better way for us to be able to start spring practice tomorrow than to have him here and to hear what he had to say this morning, so. Make sure tomorrow, and we continue to go, take care of each other and hold each other accountable and make sure each and every one of you in this room are the strongest link.